Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Today, we're going to talk about how we turn a pile of recycled plastics into a classroom-sized version of a stomp rocket. Now, there's a lot of science in these stomp rockets, and most of it has to do with forces and motion. The energy from my hand slamming into the bottle forces the air through the straw and launches the rocket. So how do we use these recycled plastics to make our own desktop-sized stomp rocket? Now, if we zoom in and take a closer look at this, I think we're going to find it's a very simple build with very basic materials. My rocket is just a post-it note. My straw is a straw, but you're going to notice here when I take it out, it fits perfectly into the nozzle, and I did that by adding some tape to the end of a straw, and now I just have a recycled plastic bottle. That's going to be my launcher. So what kind of plastic containers can we use for our desktop stomp rocket? Well, we need something that can hold air, but also something that's strong enough to take the force of my hand slamming into it again and again and again. So these are some of the containers we thought would work pretty well for our stomp rocket. Juice pouches, little plastic juice bottles, even some applesauce or yogurt that was stored in pouches that have a nice opening and seem like they're easy to blow up, put the air back in, and they're going to be able to hold up with the force of my hand pounding into them. So we're going to pick this little pouch and a straw, and the straw is going to be our stem that's going to hold our rocket. You're going to notice something. When I put the straw in the opening, it fits, but it's pretty loose. So the question is, how do I make this straw fit tightly so that I get a nice clean seal so all the air is forced through the straw and pushing my rocket instead of seeping out where the straw goes into the container? We decided we were going to try and use tape to make the outside diameter of the straw bigger so it fits better in that opening. Now, you could use any tape, duct tape. We decided we're going to use masking tape that most people would have in a classroom or their house. We've zoomed in so you can take a closer look at how we're going to do this. So I'm going to go to the end of my straw, get the tape started, just very carefully wind the tape around the straw. I didn't pick a super long section because I'm not sure how big I have to make it. So I'm going to test as I go. Yep, getting there. Need a little more tape. What's nice about this, if I make it too big, I can always pull the tape off. Let's give it a try. Now I'm getting a nice snug fit. I think this will work. Now, it seems like I have a really snug fit, but I might want to reinforce this with a piece of tape just on the outside. This is where I might want to use some colored duct tape just for a splash of color. So let's test this and see if our design for the launch system works. I can smash it, put air back into it, again, and again, and again, and I think we have a working launcher. Now it's time to make the rocket. Now, in another video, we're going to talk about making different types of rockets that we can launch from our desktop stomp rocket. But today, we're just going to use post-it notes. You're going to need a stapler and a straw and maybe a piece of tape. Now, we've zoomed in so you can get a better look at how we make our rockets, but we're just going to use post-it notes. You can use longer ones or square ones. For this, I'm just going to use my square ones. Now, the reason we use post-it notes is because they have a little sticky part, and that's going to help our rocket stay together. I'm going to take the same size straw I'm using for my launcher, and that's going to help me wrap up my post-it note around the straw. I don't want it to be too tight, but at the same time, I don't want it to be too loose. You're going to see the sticky part. I'm going to end with the sticky part so it actually helps hold my rocket together. I slide it off. I'm almost there. Now I just need to run a piece of tape to hold my rocket together. And now it's time to make the top part sealed off. To do that, I'm just going to pinch the top, fold a little bit over, and how do I keep it so it doesn't open back up on me? Well, I could tape it, but in this case, I'm just going to use a stapler, put in one staple, and my rocket is ready to launch. Now comes the best part in any STEM design challenge, the testing, especially when it comes to rockets. Let's see if my rocket slides over my straw. It feels like a good fit.
3, 2, 1.
I have a powerful launching system. Now we have to test it again just to make sure it works. Charge the system. load the rocket. Now the nice thing about using a bendy straw is now I can change my launch angle. We're gonna try launching right at the camera. Line up my sights. 3, 2, 1. So we've built our desktop Stomp rocket, but how do we tell how good it is? Well, scientists gather data, and we need to gather data to see if we can make this better. We need to look at things like how high the rocket goes, how far the rocket goes, how long the rocket stays in the air, and how much force I apply to my launcher. Real scientists who build rockets look at those kind of things, and we can look at those things too with our desktop Stomp rocket. Now we found that our rocket easily hits the ceiling, and if we want to get a better measurement for how far it goes, we're going to have to change our launch angle, and that's the nice thing about this bendy straw. It seems to hold the angle pretty well when I adjust it, but you'll notice it doesn't quite hold it perfectly. And to change that, to modify that, we're going to use a paperclip. All I'm going to do is just unbend this paperclip. The paperclip's nice because I can bend the paperclip, and it's going to maintain that angle or shape that I bend it to. So if I attach this paperclip to my straw, I can now change my launch angle and measure with precision using a protractor. So I've attached my paperclip with tape to my straw, but you'll notice something. I really don't have much space left for my rocket to slide onto the launcher. I think I might have to go back and modify this and make a little extension that lets my rocket sit nice and securely on the launcher. Now to make our extension, I pulled out a bunch of different straws of different sizes, and we're going to test it out. I might want to use a skinny straw that actually slips down into my launcher, or I could use a bigger straw that slips over top of the launcher. I can try out all these different ones. Now if one's really too big, I might be able to make a slit in the end, and that allows me to change that opening of the straw. But once I find the perfect size, now all I need to do is tape my extension to the launcher. I might be able to trim it, and I'm ready to go. So we have our extension secured to our launcher. I can now precisely change the launch angle of my rocket. Now, because this straw is bigger in diameter, I had to make a new rocket that custom fits our extension perfectly. Now we're ready to give this thing a test fly. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, and we have liftoff. There's so much more we could do with our desktop Stomp rocket. We could try using bigger pouches. In another video, we're gonna talk about modifying the rocket itself to make bigger rockets, heavier rockets, lighter rockets, adding fins, adding nose cones. And then in a third video, we're gonna talk about how we made a Stomp rocket for our desktop on a 3D printer. If you want to learn more about forces in motion or other rocket design challenges and STEM builds, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demo. Science is so cool, especially when you get to launch rockets.